Greetings, welcome back to Pyre. Let's continue on our journey. Right with Dromor Valley. The climate here in Dromor Valley is hot and uncomfortable. On top of that, we have a story. Oh? Can we go home? She must have latched onto the undercarriage as you crossed the ridge. Her memory is out, though you sense she means no harm. You need but say the word, Hedwyn. Oh, come on, you can be serious, Jody. She's just some kid who managed to climb aboard. Awaken undetected, but still. Do it, Jody. Rodario approaches the girl and looms over her. Listen to me, girl. We cannot guarantee that we shall get you home, or any of us. But at present, we have room for you and adequate provisions. You may accompany us for the time. Rodario leaves without awaiting a response, presumably to make room in the wagon for your new guest. The stowaway is overjoyed at this. Really? You're so kind, you're the most kind to someone you just met, like me. May the eight scribes smile upon you all. She claps her hands, bursts into laughter, and performs some sort of dance. Rookie stares at all and needs it goes ahead with. What gives? First the reader, now we're taking her on? What, we're gonna take in every night-beaten driving behind now? Huh? Easy, Rookie. I think he would want for us to bring this one along. Who? Sandalwood? I thought you said he has to find someone to fit in every type of mask. Yeah, as I can tell, yours would fit him just fine. Yes, that we use our best judgment. Besides, we send her away, she'll go tell anyone she finds about us. We can't risk that right now. I can come in? It's very hot and I'm a little thirsty and a little tired too. Yes, you're welcome here with us. One question though, what do we call you? This is embarrassing, I think, but I don't know for sure. This is just back home, they call me lots of names, like for the color of my hair. They made fun for you just cause you got gray hair? Vistalia. That's it, my name, it rhymes with gray. My name is they called me lots of names. You sense the girl is struggling to recall it as certain name prefer the best suited you. You sense her name is Faye. You suggest that the stowaway girl's name is Faye. Why, that's it! My name is Faye! My name is Faye! Where I'm from, they call me Faye the Fair, but I guess maybe you don't have to say that but because I didn't really like it. Your fellow exiles decide to bring Faye along for now. She almost collapses from exhaustion, so you take her in and show her somewhere that she can rest. That joined the group, she's tired but excited. The black wagon arrives in somewhat peaceful stretch of Dromor Valley. Your companions wish to hold up here for the night. You fair and all of you are too time to rest. Faye seems to be recovering well since you found her. She seems fascinated by everything and everyone in the wagon. Oh, Highness, you are the one who knew my name. You guessed it right, you did. Thank you for your hospitality. I've just been eating your veins and talking to the wagon. This wagon, he and I are the same age, almost to the very day, but I am older by 3 days. So I'm giving him a hard time. Little brother, I call him. He's a good wagon, isn't he? He'll take us very, very far. Little brother, sure, he pulls my hair at times and I don't like it very much. with his family. I'm happy to be here with my family. I thought that I had lost them all again. I thought that I had lost all of them all. Oh, but we have stopped now, haven't we? Then I should go outside to dance in case the scribes are watching. Bye, miss. Smiling back at you, she glances out the door. Your fellow exiles are taking a moment to unwind. Jodaria motions for you to join them. Best get used to your new life here, reader. We seldom get such moments of reprieve. Perhaps some further study of that book shall pass the time. You could join me for a little stroll if you're feeling up to it. Always happy to be brought around here. Or you could teach us for what you know. Prepare us for the next ride. In any case, we do what we can to stay busy. Keep the sense of isolation well at bay. At certain junctures, you may choose from several vocations. Mentor and companion. Teach your fellow exiles of the old ways to raise the individual rank interesting quickly. Study in private, hone your skills as a leader to grant small global bonuses to your fellow exiles on the right. Search for sources, search for the surrounding area for valuables, add to Black Widow's stash of goods. Having gained knowledge from the Book of Rites, you can impart some of its teachings. As each exile's path toward enlightenment is personal, you will have to mentor them one at a time. Sure, sister, I could go for some enlightenment right about now. Make that a edge of. You'll illustrate to Ricky some of the intricacies of the rites, focusing on how all three in a chamber rite can move and act as one of mine. You sense you grab some of the gold to. See that, Johns? The old Rookie Tales got somebody in him yet. I got to hand it to you, sister. The ghost cried as barring away far. I better go lay down. The path leading further west splits off. And once again, your fellow exiles turn the choice of where to go over to you. Fair seems enthusiastic for whichever road you choose. Is behaving stranger than usual as you pass through the dusty waste of Blue Hive. The scribes! I think they're here! I think that they're here! Can you feel the presence in the sand, in the air, and all about? At first, you pay little heed, but later you observe your fellow exiles seem to be in better spirits than before. Perhaps it was the previous day's rest that did them good. Your companions gain plus one presence for the next fight. Road to the spearing of Jamur, you hear all about the rolling slag market, which appears to be nearby. Ricky insists you take a look at first at the end. The last emperor. How many nations did I score in the name of Soliamar? How many countries fell before our spears and blades? Such questions matter less to me with every passing victory. Our legions swelled across the land and our dominion grew. The Emperor Soliamar paid all this little heed. He only tended to his personal affairs, allegiance relished the autonomy. He did not know that the Emperor cared nothing for his legions, nor his people, cared only for that which was before him. One day, he learned of such a thing as to befit his name, and vowed to seek it out. Edwin motions for you to join him, his easygoing smile on face. You ask before how come you can conduct the rites yourself? It's a fair question, and I wanted to respond. It's not that we don't think you could do it. I told you when we met, you're tougher than you look. It's just the connection to those books, to us. We need your guidance out there in the field. We can't do this ourselves. I've made that clear. Incipare. You've made that clear. You're our leader. Out of all of us, you have the most important job. Nor do we have substitute if you decided that job's not for you. He pauses for a moment and his expression softens. Visalium. Look, we'll help each other to get out of here. And as for the rights, we don't want you to feel left out. Every time we go out there, you're right there with us. Far as I'm concerned. Anyway, I'll leave you to it. Thanks for hearing me out. He nods to you in a reassuring way as he departs, leaving you to consider what he said. Hey guys, hey, how is it going, Mr. Grintel? Been a while, know that. Hey Yoran, it's going. Say, how come you set up a shop all the way out here? Isn't it a little out of the way? Well, let me just say you guys, you ain't my only customers. You see, Dad and I, we do this business pretty good. We've been around the block and so. As one keeps blathering rookie signals to you in a footy way. Yes, that's your sister. Got an informant says there's something here connected to the rice business. See if you can spot it. Be able to pawn some of our stuff to make it great. And don't even worry about Falcon Home. So anyway, you guys got something for me or what? The plane parcel we got there? I could take it over your paws if you want. You know, I'll take it, Mr. Grintel, but you drop a pretty hard bargain. Now, are you gonna take something on my hands here, or what? That's a wonderful finger it has got there, you know? And you got yourself a real good deal from me as well, so thanks! Apparently one of the spoilers picked up a little edge out of the finger in your eyes. I mean, just a question of focus to try it out. Anyway, that over here, his feet, you know, if we're having some trouble with his feet, getting you something or other from all the hooping on. And so you see, Yuki indicates to you that now would be a good time to depart. Hey, Mr. Grintel, and your friends with too, I like her, seems real nice, you know? As you complete preparations for the rites to commence, you notice Fair approaching. Notice too that she's wearing a companion's raiment. You can go home. There, I thought I made myself quite clear that you were not to touch those robes. Oh, I'm sorry, Mr. Dario, I just thought that maybe you were being fine at the time. Unbelievable. Something's happening in the sky. I think we are.
Reader, what brings you to the spring of Jomir? Why, it must have been the stars. Although it seems that your triumvirate now numbers 4 exiles, not the expected 3. The rules of the rites were not created for you to besmirch. Prepare now to confront the fate. They still honor the traditions of the scribes, and surely have been longing for this chance. But first, you have a choice to make.
The sky burns bright once more as your next adversary in the right approaches. At his side is an intense young man. I'll you, exiles of the night winds, and I'm grateful that you chose to grace us with your presence once again. I'm called Talbot Oldheart, and this is my son, Almer. We need not greet them, father. We shall face you in the field this night, and may the victors by a burn eternal. But first, we offer you a token of good faith. It shows appreciation that the night winds have returned. Talbot approaches you with something in his paw. You sense his motives are sincere as he hands to you a small talisman. Tailwind Crest. Grant the breath to still weakness. That girl was very kind and his son, he was so caring, wasn't he? Then can we start around to help you beat them? We need 3 of us exactly to conduct the ride. But we've got 4 now, besides the leader. This ought to be her call. If someone has to stand aside this time, I volunteer. Now volunteering, Chan, it ought to be the leader's call, remember? Very well then, leader. Who shall it be? Henceforth you shall choose 3 exiles to conduct each ride.
Who shall conduct the rite? Brookie.
Don't have to tell me twice, sister.
Hedwig.
You don't have to do this, but I'll do my best. As you will.
It is done.
Maybe next time I can help, okay, miss? Night weeks, I trust you all well prepared for this old eyes and see that the ride shall be commencing momentarily. As you quite ready to, my son? I hope so, father. Heal. Now, let me show you.
Begin. I almost pity what transpired there. In honor of the scribes. Good. With grace.
Look forth, my son. The waters of the Jomir man-made brings blessings unto us this eve. Perhaps our chance has come at last. We need more than blessings to prevail against them, father. Please, keep fighting.
A boon come from the stars themselves. But shall it be enough for Dalbert and his faithful son? Edwin plunged into their fire. Someone there rose to the occasion. Absolution. No more than a lick of flame remains. The orb slips from your clutches. Shame. Well, now that was exciting. Unfortunate for the fate. And it is done. The Nightwings prevail. T'was a glorious performance, I must say. Perhaps you shan't be quite so fortunate next time.
I guess we won. We did it all right. Alas, that in so doing you said that the family we confronted. Exile of the Nightwings, it all is yours, and may you earn your freedom. Father, the dawn may have been ours. We failed, and I have failed you. Nonsense, we are the fate. We do what is ordained and nothing less. Now let us go, my son, for I'm weary once again.
There is much to learn from this experience.
I think I begin to understand something of all this, my friend.
The Master General reveals his stratagem. Witness the rites firsthand and be inspired. Until the stars align.
Hello, excuse me. I mean, would you excuse me for a moment? You're one of them. What do you want? Father needs me. I'm sorry, I think that I forgot what I was going to say. I'm so embarrassed. What's the matter with you? It is against the rights for us to even speak like this. I didn't know that, I don't think. No one said anything like that to me, but then all this is very new to me, and so I did for me. You cannot be serious. Yes, I mean, I like to laugh, a lot, and you, how about you? This is Nightwing's trick. Father told me not to speak with any of you. But I just... I have to go. Wait, Anna, wait! I think that was your name. Was that even your name? Wait... As you return to the wagon, after thwarting the fate, you notice the dialtons up in front. Where did you go? Wait, the sleeping guy? The minstrel, he's gone. You see, it is true. There's no trace of the lone minstrel who had been lying still in the corner of the wagon all this time. You join the others and search for him outside. Your fellow exiles have revealed nothing to you of the lone minstrel or how they found him. Though you sense their concern as they scour the vicinity for him. You worry about the minstrel, my friend. You worry about the stars. Wherever they guide us, we're going. We gaze upon the stars once more. Oh, the midnight star. The midnight star burns bright over the standing stones of the edge of flagging lands. Everyone, we're headed back east, all the way across the valley, towards the Cane of Hope, then. That's right, we have to risk it. What if that minstrel doesn't turn up by then? We shall find him. on this night or another. They continue searching for some time. However, the minstrel is nowhere to be found. After having thwarted the Fae in a decisive victory last night, you find Fae off on her own. You sense she wants to talk about your decision to exclude her from concluding the ride. Oh, hi Liz, I'm sorry that I used your rope, although they didn't use a thing. I learned a lot from watching, though. I did, just being there with all the rest of you, and we prevailed. The others were so brave. Maybe someday I can be like them and prove myself to all of you and to the scribes, but I'll be patient, promise. She goes to check on things outside, listens that she has no misgivings about what transpired, and is more interested now in finding out about the missing minstrel. And that's the night. Now, thank you. Bye bye.